right, if you think the economy is improving, jobs are growing, and the worst is over, our next guest says, sadly, you are dead wrong.
Joining us now, the author of The Real Crash, Peter Schiff. Pete, thanks for joining us. What do you mean? The worst isn't over? We're not turning the corner? Things aren't getting better?
Hardly. We've actually made all the problems worse. You know, when I wrote my original book, Crash Proof, How to Profit from the Coming Economic Collapse, in that book, I forecast the bursting of the housing bubble, the ensuing financial crisis, this great recession. But what I was really concerned about was not that. I thought the crash was going to come from what the government would do to try to revive the economy. That was the real crash. It's still yet to come, and it is the subject of this new book.
So you don't think anything has changed that allowed this crash to happen in the fall of 2008?
No, the problems are much worse. We're much more deeply indebted now than we were then. All the problems have been exacerbated. And what we have now is not a legitimate recovery. All we've done is borrow additional money and spent it. And we're counting the spending as economic growth when it's not. The debt is growing much faster than the GDP. And ultimately, we're going to have to pay this money back with interest. And the only thing that's keeping us afloat right now is 0% interest rates.
And why are they 0%?
Well, because the Fed...
It's counterintuitive that, you know, we keep telling people, you know, that debt clock right there is going to come back and bite us in the rear sometime, but it hasn't done it yet. There's no inflation.
Well, sure there is, and it's the inflation that's helping keep interest rates so low because the Fed is monetizing debt, it's printing money and buying treasuries. See, the biggest problem with the U.S. economy is that interest rates are too low. Interest rates are probably the most important price in a free market. They're involved in one side of every transaction. They need to be set by the market. Instead, we're setting interest rates the way the Soviet Union used to set the price of bread. And because they're too low, we borrow too much, we spend too much, we don't save enough, we don't produce enough.
You think we have to go bankrupt?
Well, we are bankrupt.
But you want us to declare bankruptcy?
Well, what we need to do, we have to let interest rates rise. But the problem is, when interest rates go up, the U.S. government can't afford to pay the interest on the debt, let alone the principal.
What do you mean, let interest rates rise?
Well, the Fed is keeping them down.
Yeah, but you're saying eliminate the Fed, then?
Well, no, the Fed just has to let interest rates go up. The Fed has to stop buying bonds.
They set a rate. And they set the rate at zero right now. So
right, but that's too low. Let the market set the rate. How can the rate be zero?
You just said, on one hand, let the Fed set the rate, but then on the other hand, let the market say it's either one or the other.
Right. Well, the Fed can still be there and not set rates. It can let the market do it. Or the Fed has to move rates higher because rates are much too low. Nobody can make any money saving. Nobody's saving, so we don't have any legitimate capital to finance investment. We have to borrow it all from abroad. But when we let interest rates go up, the U.S. government can't pay its debts. Many of our major banks are going to fail. You think that $2 billion loss at J.P. Morgan is big. Wait till you see how much J.P. Morgan and Morgan Stanley and Bank of America are going to lose if the Fed lets interest rates go to where they need to go.
The name of the book is The Real Crash. Peter Schiff is just getting started. The book just came out, and he predicted everything that's happened before. And I hope you're wrong, but you seem very confident that you're right now. Peter, thanks so much.
Sure.
Thank you, Peter.